For years, doctors have studied concussions in athletes, trying to figure out how exactly to detect them and trying to find ways to prevent them. And while they've come a long ways in their research, there's still more work to be done.
There's been a lot of confusion as to what this entity is and what the mechanism is, and therefore not understanding that completely, we don't have a rational way to not only treat, but really detecting and preventing.
Dr. John Che is the director of rehabilitation research for Metro Health Medical Center. He's one of many attending this conference about concussions in downtown Cleveland. More than a dozen experts gave presentations. They talked about a variety of issues, including traumatic brain injuries in soldiers coming back from war and concussions in sports.
Girls soccer has really taken off in concussions. And again, you know, the argument is that maybe they should wear helmets or they shouldn't head. But then you look at what we know about football players and maybe helmets aren't protective. So I think that's where getting everybody together across a variety of disciplines, taking care of a variety of different sports, really helps us understand just what is a concussion and what do we need to do about it.
Dr. Susan Joy works in sports medicine for the Cleveland Clinic. She says it's not only important for doctors to be aware of what's happening, but parents too. Dr. Che says he couldn't agree more.
So I think the big message here is this. If there is any evidence of an impact in the brain, with or without loss of consciousness, there is a possibility that a concussion had happened. Do not simply relegate it, oh, it'll get better. Go see a healthcare professional, go see a primary care doctor, and have that evaluated. Don't let it go.